Hey y'all, it's Meaghan. If you're returning to my channel, welcome back, and if you're new, welcome aboard. I figured I would talk about something that has been in the news. Several of you reached out to me on Instagram, and thank you to Tracy and Peter, I know for sure, sent it to me. Anyone else? Sorry, I can't remember. But I know that several people were interested in kind of like my hot take on the issue that Jungle had. If you haven't seen, if you were under a rock somewhere, a Jungle Cruise boat sank last week, and I have mentioned in my Jungle Cruise fun facts video that I did a couple of years ago, which I will link up there and down in the description if you haven't seen it and you'd like to check it out. I mentioned in that video that there had only been one boat to sink over the Jungle Cruise's history, and that was the Sank Sadie. That is not true anymore, because as you saw last week, Bertha done gone and done it again, y'all. Bertha's the one that died on me. Bertha was the one that sank last week, the Bomacondi Bertha. And, what would we do without Bertha? So I figured today I would talk a little bit about kind of what happened for those of you who have not seen it, and kind of how I think that it happened, why it happened, that kind of thing. So we're gonna go into some Jungle Cruise news. Cruise news. Yeah, that's what we're talking about today. So, yeah, it's pretty self-explanatory. A Jungle Cruise boat sank. The big question is, how and why does this happen? I don't know for sure, because I wasn't there. But if I was to take a guess as to what happened, I would say that the boat was loaded, not improperly, but in such a way that it facilitated that to happen. If you've ever been on the Jungle Cruise and you're sitting, especially like at the back, you can really tell. If you look out of the boat, you're riding really low in the water. The water is very close to like where the edge of the boat is already. That's just kind of the nature of the boat. It kind of dips down some once there's weight on the boat. So my thought is there was some uneven weight distribution. So one side was heavier than the other, and that could be for a variety of reasons. A lot of times it's because people scoot around from the seats that they have been set in initially, and to get better pictures or whatever, they scoot a lot of times to get away from the engine if you're at the back of the boat. But people move, and that displaces the weight distribution. It disturbs it, so that can make the boat ride differently. So if the weight was even when it left the dock, which is the goal, every skipper is like looking for that to make sure that when they load people onto the boat that it's pretty even weight-wise. If there's like 15 kids on this side of the boat, we can't have 15 adults on the other side. It's just not going to equal out. So, you try to keep things even so that the boat goes out with both sides pretty level. Now, if people start moving and this side starts leaning a little bit because this side is suddenly heavier, then where that water was, a few inches from the edge of the boat, suddenly it's over the top of the boat. So that could happen. Boats also can spring leaks. I don't know for sure which one of these happened. If I had to guess, based on how quickly it sank, according to the fellow who was Matthew, I think it was Matthew Vince, who was telling us all about it on Twitter, and he's the one who all the news outlets have gone to. His are the pictures that you've seen plastered all over the internet. According to him, it took about a minute from, we're going along, we're cruising, we're good, to we're like in a foot of water. So that makes me think that it wasn't just like a leak that sprung, because that wouldn't have happened that fast. That makes me think that we've dipped, water has flown in, and all of a sudden we are taking it on, and we're taking it on fast. So in my mind, that's what happened. Once again, I don't actually know. I wasn't there. It looks like it was like right where you have the Congo Nile transition, like right where the camp is with the gorillas attacking the camp, and right as you're going into the Nile. That looks like where it's at to me. I can't tell 100%, but that's where it looks like it was. And as was mentioned in every news article that you've seen, Reedy Creek, the Disney World Fire Department, got out there really, really quickly. They got them all off within like 20 minutes. They were out there and evacuated. So it wasn't a big deal. And for anyone who is worried about, oh my gosh, these people now have wet shoes. They didn't go on Splash Mountain. They went on the Jungle Cruise. They weren't expecting to get wet. Disney took care of them. Trust me, Disney. When something catastrophic like that happens, Disney is definitely taking care of those people forever. They probably all got brand new shoes and clothes and socks to be warm and dry and not have little wet blisters happening. And I feel absolutely certain that they were comped food and rides and fast passes. I'm sure all of that was given freely. I don't know. If anyone happened to be on the boat and you're seeing this, like, please let us know. What happened? What'd you get? Because people are all freaking out. Oh, they had to have wet shoes. They almost drowned. It wasn't that big a deal. It's only happened twice, but it can happen. So the boat took on a little water. She went down. Poor Bertha. For anyone who is wondering what the protocol is, if you are the skipper on that boat, presumably the skipper followed the correct protocol. I don't know who the skipper was, but that's why there are radios on the boat, so that if something happens like that, you can immediately get in contact with someone and you can let them know, hey, this is the situation that we're in. We need someone to get out here and help us, because, you know, people were climbing up on the crates and we don't want you to stand on the crates. But in this instance, it was okay. People could stand on the crates because, you know, the water was up over their shoes. So that the skipper, from all accounts, just reacted very quickly. And, you know, it seems like the crew had a pretty good sense of humor about it. And the skipper was going along with it, too. And kudos to all of the Reedy Creek people who got out there and got them evac'd really quickly. So I wonder which direction people got evac'd, because normally if there is an emergency evac that's happening because of something, you know, weather-wise or some kind of threat that's happening, if you have to evac the boat not because of a mechanical issue, then you go to the temple. There is actually a tie-off spot in the temple that you don't really pay attention to, but it's in there, right over near all the jewels and the little sneckies and stuff. There's a spot in there that is designated as the evac spot if you have to evac Jungle Cruise. So the fact that they couldn't get there because they literally were just like cruising along and then all of a sudden, Titanic, we're down. They had to evac where they were. So I'm curious, did they just like go on a little off-road trip through the jungle? I'm not gonna lie, I'm a little bit jealous because I worked there and never got to go prance by the camp and go see my gorilla friends up close. But yeah, so I don't actually know. Sorry if you were hoping for some like big grand explanation, but I don't know all the facts. I basically know what y'all know, other than having a general idea of maybe what could have happened to cause it, just because I have a modicum of experience on the actual ride vehicle. But other than that, all I know is Bertha. Lord bless Bertha. So that's it for today. Just talking a little bit about some of the hot things happening in Jungle Cruise news, because I think it would be a little strange of me to not even address that situation as it was happening. One other thing I want to mention is if you are not following along on Instagram with the Disney Bound Challenge, it is super, super fun. You don't have to follow along with me, but if you want to, you can. But just go on there and have some fun with it. Today's theme was Disney animals. So any guesses here? If you don't follow me on Instagram, if you do, no cheating, because you saw this yesterday. So if you don't follow me on Instagram, any guesses as to who I am? I am a Disney bird. I wore white out before Easter just for today, so there's that. The makeup is a little bit of something to go along with it, so let me know your guesses down there. And if you are interested in following along with, I'm going to try to do every day. I did every day last year. I'm going to try to do every day again this year. It's super, super fun. My Instagram is Skipper Meaghan, because I'm super creative. You can follow along there. But make sure that you are just following along the hashtag Disney Bound Challenge, seeing all the great costumes that people come up with. And if you aren't familiar with Disney Bounding and you want to know more about it, make sure that you go check that out or ask questions down there. And I will see you guys in my next video. Bye, y'all.